Welcome back to GTA. Sad Games, and Andrew, how you doing?
That guy totally just fucking. Oh shit!
Jesus Christ! How do you mess up this bad so fast?
Forgot I wasn't gonna fucking arrest myself.
Holy shit! Did you just die in the first minute of this episode?
Wait, it's that cop. Oh, that cop was about to get run over.
I'm pretty sure you just died in the first minute of this episode.
That's fine.
Holy fuck.
I didn't care. That's a good way.
That's got to be a record for the series.
It's a good way to restart. So, let's see.
You have 60 separate minutes to die, and you chose the first one.
Yep.
Holy
a
shit.
A hick hospital. I don't know if I trust
well,
that.
Well, you lost your wanted level. Congrats. I guess that's efficiency.
Ah, whatever, money.
That probably took less time than it does to lose your wanted level normally in this game.
All right, let's see here. Map.
Holy shit. Do you remember what you were doing?
Nope.
Besides being stuck as Trevor, doing Trevor missions. Is that really... Do you see that as the fastest way to navigate the map?
Yes.
Because you were literally a centimeter away from the Trevor icon on the map. But you chose to scroll through like 20 items on the map instead of just nudging it.
Oh my god, this fucking town has nothing. Just nothing. My god, why do I have to play as Trevor for so fucking long?
It gets worse, because you totally come back here all the time.
This fucking town has nothing!
A major part of the plot takes part in this town.
I just stole $22 from that guy.
It or not. Really good at stealing money from people's bodies without actually touching them. Anywhere besides the face. Just kind of wearing. Is he wearing a skirt? Oh, it's a jacket.
I just kicked a guy out.
Oh, he's alive. He's going for it.
He missed.
He's running away.
Get back here.
Are you going to outrun a coyote?
No, I'm going to my house.
I don't think it's your house. Oh, over there. The golf cart.
You asshole. Fuck you. Whatever. Are you still following me, prick? Get out of here. Can I go through this door? No? Okay.
I like how I beat this game and almost completed all of the single-player content in general, but I never realized features that you know about now.
Wait, what?
The way, it's because of this Let's Play we discovered that you, maintain wild level when you save and quit.
I've been trying, Trevor.
Because you always end episodes punching people out.
Come on over here, alright? I ain't gonna hit you. I've been trying.
I know.
Oh.
Why I gotta punch the retard guy?
I thought you said you weren't gonna hit me.
I thought you said you were gonna find fucking Michael Townley.
There's two Michael Townley living in LS. One is 83, and the other one is at kindergarten. I asked a teacher to put him on the phone just to be safe. Call the cops. I ain't no molester, Trevor.
Shut up before I molest you, all right? Now,
oh,
is there anything else?
I look through the phone directory. I did find a Michael DeSanta, about the right age, married with two kids.
What's his wife's name?
Amanda.
Amanda?
Yeah.
You're a genius, you moron. Come on, come here.
That statement was contradictory.
You're a genius.
God damn it!
Don't ever not tell me things I want to know!
What?
Run, you little bastard! Get out here! We're going to Los Santos!
Trevor's such a piece of shit.
Not you, me and Wade.
What about me?
You're CEO of Trevor Phillips Enterprises. Find us some business so that we can make some money. And tidy my shit up. Let's go, Wade, come on.
Poor
Wade.
Little handicapped kid.
I'm joking. You can suck me off.
God, Trevor is such a
fucking ass.
What the fuck?
Someone's shit just flies right over that guy's head. I can't tell if we're supposed to think that his brain is addled by drugs, or if he's just like a normal some sort of retarded person, or if he's just a simpleton. If he's just generally stupid.
I think he's just generally stupid.
I don't know.
I mean, look at this town. Most people that live in this part of town are probably generally stupid.
So he's just inbred then?
Yeah, he's just probably inbred. Oh, Jesus. Sorry. I forgot what the break was.
This is supposed to be California, I think.
Yeah. I mean, anything that's named Los, whatever, is supposed to be California.
Yeah.
We're the only state that's got a shit ton of Los.
What about New Mexico?
New Mexico doesn't count.
Why not?
Because it's still called New Mexico. It still has Mexico in it.
What? Why is it not? It's still a fucking state.
Because they don't get to be a real fucking state until they get rid of Mexico out of their name.
Christ.
Oh my god, that's semi. Wait, what are we doing?
You're still dealing with the Lost.
Oh, Jesus. I thought we're done with these fucks. I thought we're going to Los Santos.
Yeah, you are. Of course, you're dealing with the Lost.
I don't even know how that happened. Oh my god, I just fired
again.
I'm
not entirely sure what you bounced off on that angle.
I don't either.
I'm a little impressed.
Oh. That startled me, actually.
Right now, you're kind of learning like the downside of having a fucking open-top truck all the time.
What?
It's raining.
So?
And the graphics are glitching. The fuck?
The asshole's here. They slipped. Ice took a hold of this whole place.
You don't want water on your upholstery. Makes it mold.
Oh, are they coming to the fucking place where I just massacred everyone? And they thought that I just wasn't going to show back up.
Yeah, I think this is the same place, yeah.
I have to be sneaky. How do you be sneaky again?
They want you to sneak in and plant bombs on the trailers. I don't think you actually have to do all of them. I think you just have to do a few.
Oh, whatever.
But yeah, you have to avoid bikers.
Avoid detection, because this is Splinter Cell GTA.
I don't know if being detected actually makes you fail the mission. I think it just makes stuff get more chaotic.
Which makes sense for Trevor.
I'm trying to remember. I feel like avoid detection was one of the bonus objectives or something, basically.
Okay.
Like, it's something you didn't necessarily need to do. But it's an easy mission.
Seems like it.
You just slowly and awkwardly and boringly walk through an open area and avoid the cones of vision that a few assholes have.
Do I have to get in the fucking places?
No. You have to walk up to the side of the wall that the dot's representing and use the sticky bomb. Yeah, you can probably just use it here.
Well, fucking Sticky Bomb doesn't have a choice. It's going to be there whether it likes it or not.
Yep, dot went away. You did it. Congratulations. You successfully made something blow up in the future.
Whoa.
That looks like your
future?
Again.
Okay, that guy has his back turned. That's okay.
Or does he?
Why did the cone
disappear?
Yeah.
It's a little unnerving because you can't tell what's going to... Oh, here it comes. Oh, never mind.
Nope.
He's just going to look at his fucking... Oh, he's getting on his bike.
That's fine.
I'd pay attention to where it goes.
They're just gonna ride away then. I mean,
look at the shape of the roads here. He's probably gonna loop around. I was going that way. Okay. They might go in circles for all I know. I'm trying to remember. I genuinely don't remember what happens in this mission.
Good job.
Well, we've now hit the point in this series where I've played this game like 3 months ago. Or 2 months ago. What are we, 6 episodes in?
Yeah.
Probably played two and a half months ago. Whenever this game fucking came out.
So marital I guess problems. They're obligated to bang the shit out of her?
I don't know. Can you choke them out?
You probably could. I could probably just plant bombs on him.
Just have Wade suck them off. That's what he does, right?
Is he just gonna stand there?
I guess this is his life now. He's just gonna awkwardly stand around.
Oh, that didn't stop him last time. It's fucking true. That bitch knows what's up.
Jesus.
I guess I'll make sure and have him back.
I believe they're having a few issues between themselves.
Hey, baby. I'm clean. What?
I'm one of the good ones.
I don't think that. I'll just want a hand job. You can't catch him.
What the fuck?
Wait, I don't think being...
Yeah, you can't get a cure for being sought by a crazy psychopath.
I don't think him being dirty was what she had a problem with. I think she clearly stated that being shot in the face was what she had a problem with.
More problem with all the crazy biker people is the issue. This is a really unfortunate place to live. I think the homeless people in Los Santos are better off.
That's true.
Or the homeless people in, not Los Santos, in San Andreas, I think. I don't know.
Is this San Andreas?
Oh, wait. I think the whole region is called San Andreas.
Yeah, the whole region is San Andreas.
The city is called Los Santos. I've never played San Andreas. Have you?
Yeah. Here you go.
I think it's the only GTA that's in 3D that I've missed.
You didn't miss much.
Aside from handheld. I've never played Liberty City Stories.
Missing is a very specific word that I don't think...
Well, it's frequently called the best game in the series.
Yeah, and people said that there were other Godfather movies, so people don't really know what anything is.
Well, you have opinions that tend to be out of whack with a lot of people, though.
I don't know. I think, personally, I think San Andreas, like, yeah, I guess mechanically it was good. It had a lot of cool features to it. The plot was, like, it was fucking a waste of my time.
Yeah, I think that's true for every GTA game.
No. No, it's not. There are a lot of GTA games where it's fun to do the missions. San Andreas has had a lot of fucking stuff.
I've only ever been hooked enough to actually play through the campaign of 4 and 5. And even those, like, the story is kind of shit.
Yeah. 4 was kind of shit. But
4 was more entertaining on a mission-to-mission basis because of all the ridiculous characters. Where 5
shit,
has
how
a better
the
story.
Fuck do I plant goddamn C4
gets monotonous and irritating.
In a house?
Oh, look. Oh. The same health item's still here. Maybe you just need to choke that guy out. Why don't you grab the health item?
Why don't you fucking...
There you go. You can probably just sneak up behind that guy and choke him.
Can I just chuck it?
Stop boring our audience by waiting.
Well, I'm fucking... Yeah.
Pull out a gun and start wiping everybody
like,
out.
Like, dude, you don't need to fucking get laid that bad. Like, calm down.
Apparently he's got nothing better to do. He's probably out of meth. Because you haven't been selling.
But I'm
him.
Afraid if I hit him, then the whole mission's going to fucking go to whack.
You can choke him out, I'm sure.
I'm not going to choke him out. I'm going to fucking punch him.
There's a difference.
Jesus.
Choking is a bitch move.
If you choke him out, though, then you get forward progress.
Or I can just be fucking badass.
Oh, shit. Work. You can run, you can throw it, by the way. They told you at the beginning of the mission how to throw them.
Or he just doesn't fucking care.
Just plant this blinking bomb on the side of the trailer of the poor woman that's just trying not to get fucked and murdered. So they can blow her up.
Yes. Yes. Wow, there's a lot of blinking dots that no one's noticing.
Yeah, they're pretty bright, too. You'd think that they would make the blinking dot not part of the system for the stealth bombing mission.
Yeah.
Seems a little counterintuitive to have that.
Could I just steal one of these bikes?
I love how Trevor's way of being stealthy is to just walk at a slight crouch, even though he's in the middle of the open.
This guy's so fucking dumb. Oh my god.
Like, it's raining. No one's gonna hear your footsteps anyway from this far away from people. Like,
that's true.
You have to run right up to someone for them to hear you walking in the rain.
Well, that's not true.
In a thunderstorm?
Oh, in a thunderstorm, maybe.
Like, at this point, you're
stealthy. These guys really see me?
The cone doesn't tell you whether or not they see you. It tells you where they're looking.
Oh.
You're probably too far away to be seen.
I don't know. That cone's pretty close to me.
Not if you walk away from this trailer.
I don't know.
I'm all in favor of you moving.
Well, fuck. I mean... Just turn around!
You were nearly this cautious when I saw you playing Hitman, the actual stealth
fuck!
Game. Where'd he come from?
I don't even know.
He looks like he's in the car.
How do you chuck these?
You aim and shoot, basically.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I don't know how far it goes.
Fuck.
You have extra bombs, though. You could just try.
It's true.
Unless the sound of it impacting will, like, notify everybody. Okay, now you're just flat out not... You're like... Okay.
That's a trailer.
How good is your aim, Trevor?
Not good enough.
Oh, okay. Wow. Wow. You see how that works?
That was awesome.
Oh, wait. We learned that earlier. We learned that during the mission where you were supposed to throw the gas things into the ceiling.
Oh, right. Oh,
you should have left.
Should I have?
Well, I mean, instead of standing next to the things to put bombs on.
Wow.
Yee. Okay, yeah, I'd run. Run for it instead of standing crouching. Instead of you're not going to stealth out of your bombing tactics when you're in the middle of the area that got bombed.
Stop. There we go.
How do I press the button that I hit earlier?
It's raining men.
Oh,
hallelujah.
God, your health is so low. Holy shit, you're about to die.
Well, that's not my fault. Where's Wade?
It's the dot on the map. Holy shit.
I am having trouble navigating.
I'm so proud of you. You are clearly the best player.
As long as I don't get shot.
We learned during the bank heist mission, the jewelry store heist, that whenever you throw something in this game, you automatically throw it to the exact spot on the wall you were aiming at.
Right, I forgot about that.
You don't have to arc shots at all.
Oh! Is that guy trying to come after
you? I think that was Wade. Oh, wait, never mind.
No, Wade's in the car. Wade's in the car.
Never mind.
There's a prostitute running away.
No, it's just random people that live there running into the hills. I'm not entirely sure I know what their understand what their plan is.
I don't gotta think about that guy no more.
I feel like when there's an explosion, the more the normal thing is usually like run outside to a safe distance and then turn around and like look and try to figure out what's going on.
Yeah.
As opposed to just running aimlessly into the far distance so that you can drown yourself in the lake.
They are just running nowhere.
Yeah.
You know, like
there's NPCs are about to just drown their children in the lake. That's where this is going. This is going Inception style.
Okay.
Spoilers.
Is there spoilers in there?
What?
You don't know who drowned whose kids in the lake.
Yeah, but kids got drowned in the lake.
Okay.
Oh, wait, that's not a... Wait.
That's not really a spoiler.
Wait.
You can't... It's, as long as you don't say who did it. Wait. No, wait, that's not even for Inception.
That's not even Inception.
Wow, wait.
I'm mixing up DiCaprio movies where he has two kids and a wife, and the wife dies, and the kids... And he can't see his kids.
Wow, DiCaprio, way to keep it original.
Both those movies came out the same fucking year.
Yeah. Did they?
Yes!
Holy shit.
Two movies back-to-back where he's some sort of professional with a certain skill set, and the skill set is involved in some way in the process of dealing with the fact that he lost his wife and can't see his kids for some reason. They both came out the same year.
Wow.
Yeah, that's Shutter Island. Holy fuck, it took me that long to realize, too. They even have the same big-ass backyard behind their house and shit. They might have filmed in the same fucking house. Oh, don't hit that. Okay, well, that works.
Wade.
The guy stole your car. Hit it with your car.
I'll start again. Animal, vegetable, or mineral?
Hey, how about this?
Animal, vegetable, or mineral?
Tell you a story if you promise never to speak again.
I like stories.
Oh, this is a good story.
Of course you do. This story's about a boy called Trisha.
Is Trisha a boy's name?
It doesn't matter.
Sounds weird.
Kind of does.
He was weird. He was the smartest, toughest, weirdest kid in Canada. Well, in the Canadian border region of America.
Okay.
This boy, he had all the talent, charisma,
why are you doing this?
A boy could have.
You'll see.
But he didn't know what to do with it.
He should become a baseball player.
No, he shouldn't. Because he's not a fucking sellout idiot.
Or hockey player.
He did.
Where are you?
But his coach accidentally had a stick jammed up his ass.
God.
Damn it. Where'd it go?
What are you trying to do? Did it go to the dot?
No.
The dot is in the city. You're driving
to
the city.
Where the dot is. Fuck, that sucks.
What are you trying to do?
Trying to run over a deer.
Oh. You went all that way to try to get one deer?
Yes.
It probably despawned when it got went out of my sight.
I'm a committed man. Oh my sweet Jesus.
Oh. You found the top.
The end of the fucking...
Jeez.
It's okay. Well,
there goes whatever piece of car that was. I don't even recognize it.
I'm glad we don't have a roof.
The roofs aren't important. I mean, no big deal. It's just you're old dead now.
Yeah. Like, we would probably have died from that, you know. Wait, we have to go down?
But you got stuck in the desert.
It's still San Andreas.
Best part of the state.
Oh, maybe I shouldn't be walking around with a shotgun. okay.
So, Michael, this is where dead men come back to life.
This is way too, like, I'm a cool guy scene for you, Trevor. You'll keep for another day or so. It's like the kind of shit you see in anime. Like, oh, Sasuke-kun, I know you're in this town. I will find you.
He is yelling at a city.
Yeah, like, right? This is a total Japanese anime thing.
Well, guess who's coming to shit on your doorstep, you fuck!
Wait, are you done yet?
I just can't
finish that story.
I just can't relate to Trevor's anger, which shouldn't be surprising because of all the anger he's had so far, and the part where he like murdered someone with a bottle.
Wait, Wade's cousin's apartment?
Yep, gotta have a place to stay.
Will you tell me the story about that boy, Trisha?
Ah, yeah. Where were we?
You were saying Trisha. What he could do. He couldn't throw, and his coach had a stick accident like I had one.
Right. But he could fly planes, this kid.
What?
He signed up to the Air Force to fly all day long and bomb villages and maybe, just maybe, drop the nuke.
Wow, that was some high ambitions.
Yeah. What a shithead.
An evil witch in charge of psychological evaluations told him he was unstable. Grounded him for life.
That's terrible.
That's terrible. A man who wanted to murder Catalyst is terrible.
And just then, just as he hit rock bottom, he met a fat... Ow! Silver-tongued troll under a bridge.
That's cool. What was the troll's name?
Michelle.
A lady troll?
Why does he keep giving everybody women names?
Yeah.
Michelle is a funny name for a boy.
Well, this was a funny boy. He sat under his bridge.
It's a fat joke about Michael.
Sometimes he'd go into town and rob his shops and inns and such. And he persuaded our hero that maybe he should rob people too. And you know what? Little Trisha did rob people.
Jesus.
Little Trisha did rob people. And little Trisha.
Sorry, I'm trying to read the text. And not drive.
Ever after?
For a while. Until the troll met another troll in a strip club.
Oh.
That's Amanda.
We're near Floodcap. I seen it on I-5 maps. I'll give you directions.
On the I-5 maps.
Yeah.
This guy has some really good fucking memory. Like, ah, fuck! Excuse me, sir,
all
that
the
was
reasons
a green
why
light.
Trevor is a terrible person. Only get amplified as the story goes on. Especially this whole storyline. The way he treats this guy's cousin. Who I don't think has ever met him before.
Oh, that's always a good surprise. To just have Trevor show up at your fucking
yeah,
house.
And move in his sweatpants. Who he just that his dirty sweatpants he just lives in.
Jesus!
Come to visit you, you rude fuck. Now get up off the floor and fix me a fucking drink.
Oh,
damn!
Right. I heard you was off smoking meth somewhere.
No, not somewhere. Here, he's gonna smoke meth here. Give me a fucking lighter.
Say what?
You can't smoke here.
Okay.
This is my girlfriend's place. She's at a business conference. You can't smoke here and you can't stay here.
How's it going, cousin? It's been a while.
Yeah, I ain't seen you since you was called in Evelyn's bed.
A guy was never approved.
You gotta go.
What?
She'd kill me if she knew I had guests.
It's not much of a girlfriend if she don't like your family. Now, would you get me a fucking drink? I'm not gonna ask you again.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Damn.
I ain't got no booze.
Then you go out and fucking get me something. You go.
What the fuck? This guy is so fucking, like, crazy. Right?
Yeah.
He's crazy. He just like showed up and was like, you don't have fucking alcohol?
Yeah.
Well, guess what? You're going to go
like,
buy some.
By the
some.
Way, I live here now and I'm going here to ruin your life. You're not going to do anything about it because you're a weak-willed pussy. And that's how the story goes now. Whoa. The first autosave in 25 minutes.
Wow.
Ow.
Only a silver? Unmarked. I don't know what that is.
It's not getting hit.
Oh. Oh, thank
you got,
Christ.
You got the fuck shot out of you, so you bad.
So I can finally
look at the next quest for Trevor. See the letter?
M.
Michael.
Oh, jeez. That escalated quickly.
Yeah.
Well, Michael, I'm coming.
Time to go get Michael. You should just go in your car. It's downstairs.
That's what I was going to do. I was just going to jump off the ledge, though.
You'd have to run around the building under that.
Nice.
You're going to waste my time and the viewer's time. And then you're going to trip over
I'm doing that now.
Yeah.
By this game, not knowing how to fucking get in a door.
Just tripping on cabin cones and shit. Why would you park there?
I don't,
why would you park so packed in that you can't get in and out of your car? Like, that wasn't what you did. That was
that's what the game
parking
did.
Spot. Like, that's apparently where he parks, so he can intentionally create obstacles for himself. What are you doing?
Buying real estate.
I don't know if you have money for it. Only Frank can purchase this property.
What? Wait, what? Why?
I don't know. Apparently only a black guy can buy a place that sells weed, even though you're the drug dealer character.
Oh, my axle's broken.
Clever name, Smoke on the Water. It's on the coast and they sell weed.
I just heard a radio advert about the flying school. It's in Los Santos, not saying you need to learn new things. Delete. Don't tell me how to fly my planes.
Now you know about a flight school. Yay, okay. After you've already done a flight mission.
Yeah, it's a little late for that.
Like, the mission you played was the mission out of all the game
Ooh.
Ones in the game that I had the most difficult as far as flying goes. Oh, another Rampage mission.
I like Rampage.
Is that the hipster one? Is that the hipster one?
I'm sorry.
Oh, don't
my
don't
axle.
Call the cops. I'm sorry. I'm not really
my
sorry.
My axle is so
cops.
Broken. I can't. What?
Oh, There's a random event over here. It's probably someone getting their first stolen. This was a horrible direction to choose.
Trevor,
Dad.
What are you doing?
Totally fine. Oh. Just had a couple of beers.
What are you talking about? We had like six shots.
Yeah, it's two people wanting to get. Then need a ride.
Will you two just make
so
out
if you want,
it?
You can get in the car.
What?
Hey, can you give me a ride? Just so Boy Scout there can get his buzzkill badge. There's my car.
Basically, you can pick them up and a conversation happens in the car that's silly and whatever, and you can choose to either drive them to the destination or drive them up to this place on the top of the mountain that's a cannibal cult. And then they get eaten, and then they pay you for giving them people to eat. Problematic.
Wait, is it only one guy?
Yeah, they want you to drive his son home. So you can choose his destination, or you can choose the altruist cult.
Alta place. Howick Ave.
Which one are you going to do?
The fucking cult?
Alright, so you should pick it on your map then.
Oh, I don't feel so good.
It's the A. You have to click on it though to be able to tell where it is.
Yeah,
it's up. It's up in the hill. Up, like way up.
Way up where?
Why are you going down instead of up when I say up?
Wait, how far up in the hill? Oh my god!
Yeah.
Okay, no, I'm bringing him to his destination.
Or you could just not do this.
I'm just gonna bring him to his destination.
God damn it.
There's no fucking point to bring him all the way to a goddamn.
No, I'd rather
fucking
just not do this whole thing.
Why? It's gonna take like 2 seconds.
Hey, thanks for this, man. As you can see, I.
Nice.
Me,
I love how this guy's like, please drive me home. I'm too drunk to drive safely.
And I'm just running.
I'm just going to be a danger to myself and others if I try to drive. And then he gets the car with someone who's just ramming into everything in the city. I'm okay with that.
Oh God, it's coming out the window.
Sing me a rainbow. Dear Lord. Trevor is a terrifying person. I think they specifically tried to make the least relatable character they've ever had in the game.
Yes. And they succeeded.
Because holy fuck.
His name was Wade.
Your a fool. Ditching horrible. A charming raconteur like
you're a
you.
Terrible person.
I have no empathy for the retarded kid.
Trevor just likes the word raconteur.
That tactical vomit really sore me out. Charming now. Oh, yes! I still got some cluck and bell at home from last night. I am all over that.
Try again.
I'll tell you, the planets are aligned, bro. Karma is sucking my boy right now.
I want this guy to die.
I promise you're not as interested.
Now that
you've
successfully dropped him out, you should murder him. Murder him now. Get him. Get him. He needs to die.
I'll see you around.
Get up.
Try not to pass out.
Why are you not hitting him? Why are you not hitting him? What are you doing? Oh, what? Oh, wanted level. Oh, because you're shooting him. I didn't even realize you were shooting him. I'm like, did the cops just come after you? Was he running from them shooting at you? Why are they shooting at you? Like, I was so confused by the events happening.
Well, now you know. Now you're in the loop. The loop is I just killed this fucking man.
Yeah,
he I drove him home successfully, only to murder him.
Kappa pop in his ass. Pop a cap in his ass.
Damn Kappa pop in his ass. Yeah, yes. I like that better. Kappa pop in his. Kappa pop in his.
You just have a soda bottle, but it's open, and you don't know how to seal it again, so you just shove it up his ass. Now the soda won't get out. That's the only possible explanation I can come up with for that backward statement.
He doesn't see me yet.
No homo.
He doesn't see
he
me.
He sees
yet.
You.
Now he sees me.
Now that he's turned. Hey, look, another random event, I think. Or is that a cop?
I think that's a cop.
That's just a cop getting out of his car.
What you know about me? What you know about me?
What you know about me? What you know about me? Boom, boom.
Well, I'm hoping by the time I get to the Rampage mission, it'll be A-O-Kies. What Tadaloy I am.
That song's been burning my head a little bit too much because of the fucking lips. Which I was an owner of at one point.
Fuck!
So I was like, I like singing in a rock band, and I hooked all these music games. I'll buy this new karaoke game. It should be good. And I didn't properly look at the set list of the game to find out that it has primarily ass music and
ass
like non-music.
Music.
And like
now featuring ass music from hit artists like Toots.
When you think karaoke game, you think games that display, you know, vocal prowess. and that stuff that you want to mimic for the purposes of singing, like Bohemian Rhapsody and like everything that's ever made by Queen and stuff like that.
Okay.
They had like, they had lip gloss by whoever the fuck did that song. What You Know About Me. What
but
you know
whoever
about me,
the fuck did that song.
Which is a song that where you literally never have to match the pitch because they're all talkie bits for the entire song. In a karaoke game. It's the whole song where you go, what you know about me, what you know about me. But instead you can just have it be played by holding it up to the TV and you get 100%. Which is what they made fun of in Hey Ash, What You Playing.
I didn't even think about that.
That's what they made fun of in Hey Ash, What You Playing, where the dad just is holding there, not singing, and everyone's staring at him, confused and kind of uncomfortable.
And then he gets
then
like
he gets
a perfect.
He gets the highest score ever. He's like, it's like a supernova ranking or whatever. Because you don't have to play the song to win. That's how stupid that game is.
Okay, well, Rampage is gone. That's nice.
Aw. And then they put stuff in like Weezer's Island in the Sun by Weezer.
What?
Yeah, because Weezer is the band that should be in karaoke games. Because the vocals are so. Oh
yeah.
How do you always get hit by?
Oh, yeah.
I've never had a close call with a train a single time except in a scripted event. I don't understand how you always barely clip past them or get hit by them.
Because I'm awesome.
That's an amazing coincidence that happens just when we're. It's like GTA knows we're recording a Let's Play, so it's trying to put on a show.
Look at our features. We have trains.
Yes, look at them. They're
I played.
Real.
Oh, I played a.
They're real.
What's it called?
What?
That train game, board game.
You played.
Ticket to Ride.
Ticket to Ride.
European
got
edition.
A ticket to ride.
It was. The European edition kind of sucks.
Did the European edition just have a picture of Middle Earth?
No, it had a picture of Europe. But I don't know anything in Europe.
Yeah, neither do I.
So it was like, here's your cards,
that
you have to make.
That was the whole joke.
Well, yeah, it's just, it was like, when I got the cards for telling me, like, where am I supposed to go? I was like, I don't fucking know the distance. Is this far? I don't know how far this is.
Yeah, you don't know where any of the locations are.
Yeah, I was like, it was like, from Gunderbos to, you know, Escafan.
It's not quite the same thing as drawing a card that says Atlanta.
Atlanta to Detroit. And I'm like, oh. Whereas this one was just like from one end of like Russia.
I've still never played Ticket to Ride.
Really?
Yeah.
It's
my only exposure to the game was watching it on tabletop, and even then I didn't pay enough attention to learn how to play it.
It's cool. It just.
I just know you try to build complete railroads to win, I guess.
Yeah.
Did M just disappear? Oh, okay. Okay. You're gonna creepily stalk outside the house.
I believe it.
The time of day you can awkwardly change. I guess we're just gonna listen to the radio now. Oh,
it was loading.
Oh. This? Welcome to too many characters on screen.
Very funny. You know, you're a real asshole. What did you
just
fucking say to me?
Stop it! You're ruining my fucking.
Is that the
yoga.
Trainer?
Somebody yeah.
Say yoga.
Oh shit.
No, it's a new. Trevor? It's a new trainer.
Oh.
It's a yoga trainer.
Michael.
Uh oh.
Yeah.
Amanda's like,
Shit just got awkward.
Good to see you, man. Yeah, I bet it is.
You smell horrible, by the way.
Resurrected.
I think you're wearing shit. And that Jackie you just bought at the store.
Ain't this random? Yeah, well, I got in a bit of an awkward situation. You're telling me, bro. Yeah. One of those fake your own deaths to your best buddy, and then run off with the dough, and then live in a big mansion. Awkward situations. It's one way of looking at it.
Yeah.
Any other ways of
well, I'm wearing a suit and you're wearing your pets.
But it was a long time ago, man.
Does his face look like it didn't load?
Protection
yeah.
Still am. That's great. That's great.
Jesus. Why did you leave your door unlocked?
Where are my manners, right? Amanda, it is good to see you. Oh, I missed you. You used to be fatter. Nice new tits, by the way. Jimmy, you used to be thinner. But I can't blame you. Who are you?
He also used to
who
be
are
like
you?
Namaste. I'm Fabienne.
Good lord.
He looks like he's about to rape him.
I think he pissed himself.
That looks like that's literally what he's about
Where's
to
your
do.
Sister, Jim?
I don't even mean that in joking fashion. I mean, like, he literally looks like it's gonna happen.
She's trying out for TV.
Uh-oh.
She's what?
Yeah, she's auditioning for Fame or Shame.
Fame or shame?
Uh-oh.
The fuck are you talking about?
You know, it's that talent slash skills show. She loves it. You guys know that.
What's her talent?
Dancing.
Oh, Christ. She's a horrible dancer.
Michael.
She might disagree with you on that.
Jesus Christ. What? Now? Now? Where?
The Mays Bank Arena.
Oh, little Tracy being humiliated. Let's go. We go get her.
What? Yeah.
What?
Are you gonna stand here and argue while your daughter becomes a national laughingstock?
Huh? He just completely changes tracks. Tracks immediately.
I think Trevor has a mental disorder.
Probably, yeah. Probably about all of them. If I were to guess, like every single mental disorder at once, right there.
Oh, am I getting in the car?
And they're all happening simultaneously.
Yeah, seriously.
You know, I could probably handle this myself.
He has this really weird overpowering chivalry.
Oh, that's a door.
Hours,
catch up properly. I guess I can't drive through the gate door.
Daughter, I'll handle it.
Judging by past behavior and the state of the rest of your family, fuck only knows what that means.
Hey, fuck you.
Yeah, you're a model husband and a wonderful parent. You can just tell.
You walk into my home and try to tell me how to run my life. It don't work like that, amigo. It's nice to see you and all, but you stink like piss, you got blood under your nails, and you look like you've been up for what, a week? What the fuck are you to tell me anything?
I'm someone who knows you, you fucking slippery snake. I know.
Are you serious? I made that.
Leave you, you'll just go home. We're gonna get your girl from these assholes. You're not abandoning her like you did me and Brad.
Who's Brad?
Yeah, Brad.
Is that the dead guy?
Fucker must have woke up handcuffed to a hospital gurney after that stunt of yours. He still writes to me from the joint, you know.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. So, how you been doing?
Oh, I'm getting by.
Wait, didn't he turn on Brad?
Brad's dead.
Live in Los Santos?
Brad's the guy that got buried in Michael's grave.
Okay. So where?
So they've lied to Trevor saying that he's still alive, and they write fake letters to him from Brad mail.
Oh no!
Yeah. Imagine how that turned out to be a plot point.
Oh shit, did he try to go and bust him out of prison?
You know how Trevor's not a big fan of being lied to, as we've seen so far? Yeah. Wait till he finds out more shit.
Maybe he just shouldn't have came home, or like came down.
Maybe Trevor should not be allowed to be alive anymore.
Yeah, that's also a good. That's also one I'll take.
It's he feels like a really weird parody of a lot of different types of video game players all at once.
Yeah, I see that.
Because he embodies all of the ultra-violence, nonsensical murder that happens in like every video game ever. Like the kind of game where they're like you and Anna are when you start playing Dark Souls. You're like, hey, look, an innocent person sitting on a stone. We must stab him to death. Oh no, this backfired. Like that whole thing? Like that, like the thing where gamers...
I don't like guys with clipboards.
Exactly that. that's exactly what Trevor represents. Like just completely wanton random violence for no apparent reason. But then also, strange concern with women issues. Because he's like, he just changes tracks out of nowhere to be the most chivalrous person ever.
Damn.
Fucking DeSanta, fuck, screw that! Where the fuck's Laszlo?
What? He so escalates quickly.
Yeah.
He's like, where's this person? Fuck, not that. Fuck, give me the main guy.
Like, everything else takes backseat the moment a woman's being disrespected for him. Do you remember who Laszlo is?
Yeah.
No.
That was really...
He's on the radio in, like, every GTA game. He's the little talk show guy that does ridiculous shit.
Right. Seriously?
Yeah, now he's a now he's just a character right here. They decided to make him someone you can fuck with.
Tracy DeSanta. Yes. All right, Tracy's a dancer, but she also likes acting, modeling, and working with children.
I barely actually recognize her when she looks like that.
You're so original, like a basket full of puppies, or a rainbow, or a pile of puke.
Oh.
Who are these clowns?
Oh. That's my dad and Trevor.
Two dads. Great.
Two dads.
San Andreas.
What are you guys doing here?
Yeah. What are you doing here?
Okay, I'm back.
Relax, chill. What? At home.
What is this? What the fuck is this? God, I hate this girl. I hate this fucking. I hate this.
Yeah.
All right, it's fame or shame for
if I could choose not to help her, I would just do that.
Music.
She deserves to fuck herself up. Yeah, you better hug those boobs. Of course, she has a tramp stamp.
Just took off her underwear.
what your daddy's gave you, honey.
Right in front of her dad, too.
It does. It's got a 20 in this.
Oh! Fucking do something about this.
Trevor's gonna lose. Oh, shit!
I mean, really, she does this to herself.
Whoa, Jesus,
Jesus,
Trevor.
Trevor.
She is like,
she's
such a
throwing a straight up like infant tantrum.
She does it like every time her dad shows up.
Did you see that new arc? Yeah, Tracy is the single most unbearable character in the entire story.
This is so fucking irritating. Where'd
I was
go?
Like desperately saddened by the fact that I couldn't choose to just fucking murder her. Nope, yeah, that's not the truck you're going in.
Well, I was gonna steal the car before he. Wait, Michael just got in. The truck driver didn't care.
Yeah,
like
he just sort of sat. He's like, "How you doing, buddy?"
Wait, why do I have to drive this?
Michael's an upstanding fellow. He wears a suit.
Why do I?
You're wearing this because Trevor makes bad decisions.
Why do I have to drive this?
Because I already answered this for you.
No.
Don't ask. We're not a fucking backwards popsicle stick with a joke on it. Like, the answer comes after the question. I already fucking answered
Fuck
you.
Fuck this trailer.
Holy shit, you got air. Whoa. Oh. That worked.
I'm tired of this shit.
That worked. I knew he was an asshole. No, you don't shoot that, bro. Don't. Oh. No, you're just chasing him. Push him off the fucking road. It's only a battery
car, come on! This ain't exactly a race.
Trevor could have picked any other vehicle in the parking lot.
Come on!
Hey, take a left up here!
Come on, fuck! Why can't I shoot him?
I think you have to chase him to like a specific point. A little faster,
gonna do the train track. Are you fucking kidding me? The one light.
Yeah. Calm found down. The other one. Proud of you. We can have a little fun with it. Let's not try to kill this prick, all right? When we crush his little... I think you're chasing him to a specific point. Where'd he go? Did you lose him?
No, he's right there.
Oh, there he is.
See his little fucking red rocket. Yeah. Come here. Look, you went left. Fucking cock stain. I'm gonna kill you.
His car is so bright you can see it in the distance. Thing would be full of douchebags. If I remember correctly, I think it is a mission where you're like chasing someone to a specific point. Can we speed it up a little, huh? Maybe by throwing your fat carcass over the side. Killing him might fail the mission.
I'm not trying to kill him. I'm trying to pop his fucking tire.
Oh, yeah. Dude, that is the most... If you can pull it off consistently, that is an incredible tactic to be able to do online.
Oh, yeah?
Because, like, you get thrown into a mission where it's, like, you... There'll be, like, two teams of four, and you're competing to, like... You have to go get like this package of like drugs or whatever and try to and like essentially try to take it to your base. You know what I mean? Like two teams start at remote locations, have to charge this one thing and grab it and take it back to their base before the other one does, basically. So you're like constantly like killing the person carrying it and going the other way and stuff like that.
Okay.
A great way to just completely fuck people over is instead of killing them,
you just pop their tires.
Yeah, you pop their tires when they're chasing after your guy, and now they're just useless. Because their car can't keep up, and these often take place in weird remote locations where there's not enough other cars to steal. And they're not dead, so they're not just going to respawn in a nice location.
Oh, sweet Jesus.
Because in GTA Online, when you die in those kind of situations, you respawn in a car.
Oh, really?
You immediately jump back in the action after being taken out. It's like, yeah, if you can just disable someone's car, they're totally fucked. That game's actually really interesting when you're playing something besides deathmatch, which is shit.
Why did we stop? Wait, why did he stop?
Because his car is fucked. Because he's driving a shitty battery car. Huh? I didn't mean anything by it, all right? Oh yeah. Well, that little girl sat on my lap when she was 2 years old, and I swore to God that. Well, she's like 20 years old now, and she sat on Laszlo's lap. Just a dumb A-list celebrity trying to entertain America, okay? I got a lot of stuff going on right now, dude. Besides you trying to kill me, now I got multiple sexual harassment lawsuits. Plus,
no fucking kidding!
I'm so shocked. I can't stop jacking, dude. I jack it in traffic. What's your talent, huh? I mean, aside from love and sex. Dude, haven't you seen my show? It's not live, it's not funny. That's my genius, I got no fucking talent. You clearly ain't being
humble, T. So, this is supposed to be that one guy from American Idol, right? Fucking ponytail off the
back of this guy's head. Yeah, at this point he's a parody of, I don't know.
The irony is I can't remember his name.
I can't think of his name either. There you go. Yeah, this is happening. What are you doing now?
want you to dance sexy, celebrity.
Wow, these two are kind of fun together at times.
Yeah, oh yeah, it starts off pretty nice.
I'll dance. Good. All right, now drop it like it's hot, all right? I want to see you get nice and low. Come on, lower, lower, come on.
Oh, please don't kill me, okay? I'm supposed to be on a magazine cover next week.
All right. Like that?
Get off. No!
That's the magazine cover now.
My camera, you fucking pussy. The world's gonna Christ. See your shit.
I'm going home.
How the fuck?
I'm going home. In what? The semi you stole?
Yeah. Yeah, Laszlo's definitely a parody of reality TV show stars at this point. Although in the previous games, he was like a radio host.
Yeah.
I was about to tell you the same thing.
Okay. Which he probably still is.
Meet me at Galileo Observatory as soon as you can get there.
Okay.
Who did he just call? Oh, did he just call the FBI agent?
Yeah. It's because Trevor's back.
A friendship resurrected.
Well, ish.
Yeah. That defined friendship.
I don't know about resurrected so much.
All right, well, that's pretty good.
Ryan Seacrest.
That's who it is.
That's his name. I knew it had something to do with water.
What?
That's literally the only part of his name I could think of is there's some amount of water-ish thing going on. Seacrest? That's like two words of water
Mike,
mixed together.
Hey, I'm transferring your cut of the jewel store take to your account.
Yes!
Charles has already got the house money, so
welcome
you can
to money.
There.
Thank God for that.
Go buy a theater or something.
Holy Jesus.
Oh, I'm sorry. Not even $1 million. That was pointless. No, I'm joking. The special thing that Michael can buy is he can buy theaters.
Okay.
I don't know why.
Okay.
There's just really arbitrary distinctions. Like, there's a bunch of buildings that everyone can buy, and then there's a handful of buildings only specific people can buy. So it's the guy who you helped get the bike back in the random event.
Oh.
I can't wait to show you my fixed gear bike.
Turns out if we're at Petford's really in recession proof.
Okay, what do you fucking want?
He's sending you $100,000 of stock in animal art. So now you can look at your stock and if it's ever profiting, you can sell it. That's nice. Hello, Lester. His name's on the transaction?
That doesn't seem
a little iffy.
Shit.
Made almost $1 million from Lester Crest. You know, no big deal. Holy fuck, they're mailing the shit out of you.
They are mailing the shit out of me. Okay, well.
It's a little... it makes sense, timed in with like the way that my phone works in real life, like that they... you get emails and you get text messages separately in two separate inboxes.
Yeah.
But in the context of a video game, it's kind of irritating to have two menus for this just that are just text on your screen.
That's old.
Oh Jesus, that's been sitting there for a while. Go fucking do something. Got 10 minutes to go. No one wants to watch you casually strolling down the sidewalk. What the fuck is this bullshit? You're a terrible Let's Player.
No,
I'm gonna kill you. Lester, I don't
Excuse
know.
Excuse me.
I don't know where that
me.
Sense was going.
Don't ever talk to me like that again.
Poor woman.
You see
she
what she
so
said?
She
was like,
so
excuse me.
She has so much to not live for. Yeah, I don't feel bad at all. This entire town is vacuous crap.
Yeah.
Okay. This place is literally LA, but worse. Which is hard.
Please tell me this is another place.
It's LA's where all the shitty people live.
God damn it, Franklin! What's the fucking point?
Yeah,
what?
Only Franklin.
I have received your payment. The house will soon be restored to its former condition. I am pleased you are a man of your word. I don't want to call you.
Yeah, only Franklin can have the taxi place because only like they have like voiced missions for it.
What the fuck?
Franklin can have taxi missions, and they're really exciting. They're really exciting, Andrew. Mm. Do you understand me?
No. Federal
FBI.
Bureau. Let's go to the FBI. Hey, since Franklin's gonna be the future owner, I might as well just steal a fucking cab.
Yeah, I mean, you're paying him.
This is a loan on Franklin, you know?
Yeah. A loan on Franklin for this business he doesn't own. Flawless logic.
As
Oh.
Well, that gate doesn't break down easily.
That poor reinforced fence.
I think this is their only cab.
Oh. I wouldn't imagine the other ones are actually doing stuff right now.
That'd be awesome if they weren't. This is their only cab, and
I just
stole it.
Big parking lot for only one vehicle that's not being used, so they're just not in business right now.
Who's free for a pickup? Nobody. I ain't picking nobody up in my goddamn cab.
What are you, cray-cray?
What?
It's a job offer to accept. Just press L3, or never press that.
Yeah.
Don't you dare. Ah! How did you fuck this up?
Because I keep fucking up the controls.
Do you, like, change camera angles midway through that?
No, I was about to shoot.
Oh, don't do that. Why are you pressing bumpers at all right now?
What?
Why are you pressing bumpers at all right now?
To drive? One of them's brake.
No.
Yes.
The triggers are.
They're triggers. I'm not pressing the bumpers.
You had to in order to aim at the window.
No, I shoot with L1.
Oh, what?
Yes.
No, you don't. Yeah, those are bumpers.
What? Dude, they're at the top.
Do you know the difference between bumpers and triggers?
Whatever, fuck. I don't care. I call them triggers. They're at the top.
I'm referring to them because that's we've been trained that way by Xbox. There's two bumpers and two triggers.
Wait. Okay. Whatever. You call
the important thing is that L1 is not used in driving.
Well, I'm aware of that now. Thank you. I'm very aware.
I like how 7 hours into this game and almost an hour into this episode, you're like, how do I drive? I forgot.
It's only like the main key
focus.
It's
hard. It's only the two buttons that you use in every driving game.
No, because PlayStation's fucking dumb. All right, let me just explain that. PlayStation is dumb when it comes to fucking driving shit. I hate driving stuff in a PlayStation game.
It's still completely normal for the two back buttons to be the driving ones.
Yeah, which it sometimes...
Holy shit, where is this coordinate set to? Well, I guess
see, this is why this
I guess
is honestly,
just fly there.
Honestly, this is.
Did you not click on the B?
I did click on the B. This is fucking Keith. That's why I don't use the fucking map when I just click on something.
I don't think you did.
I did. I fucking clicked on the B. Don't tell me what I didn't do. I fucking clicked.
This is user error.
No, I clicked right on the fucking B, and it didn't give me the directions exactly to the B.
This is user error.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
You can rewatch the fucking video when it uploads, and you will see I clicked on the fucking B. I have highlighted the name, and it said, like, Federal Bureau of Investigation. Clicked on the fucking X, and then I was like, okay, I'm going to the destination, but instead it brought me to a fucking hill. If I just used the stupid map feature that you bitch about all the time, it wouldn't have fucking done that. It would have brought
User
me to this destination.
Error.
No.
You're watching Andrew be bad at video games?
I am perfectly
Being
flawless
bad at
video
menus.
Games. Fuck it.
Menus are hard. Quote Andrew.
Video games aren't hard, they're dumb.
Oh. Don't. No. Okay, thank God.
Yes.
I was going to be so disappointed. If you went off that hill, I'd be like, all right, next time on Sad Games, it's the end of the episode. It's a 55-minute episode. Too bad. Get over it.
Whatever. I don't
watch
give a fuck.
Drive
I just killed a motherfucking elk.
So proud of yourself.
I am so proud of myself.
You're right over the FBI agents.
Where is this place?
You have to get out and walk around.
Do I actually have to get inside?
No, you have to walk around.
Oh.
You're gonna be on a balcony and talking to shady figures and
suits.
Come
on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on. I hate running.
Deck someone. Don't do that. Don't.
I'm not gonna deck someone.
I don't want to get this interrupted by a wanted level.
What?
Let's go down, I think. I think you go. Yeah, I think you go down there on that little walkway. Jotaro! I'm someone who wears suits. Wait, is there not a walkway? Look for a walk. No.
I'm looking for the yellow points.
It's so frustrating not having controls.
What?
It might actually be upstairs. So there's some sort of walkway that bends all the way around the outside of the building. There it is. There it is.
Oh, my sweet Jesus. I'm just going to.
Yeah, it actually took me a while to find where the fuck he was when I first got here. I walked
so
around the entire building.
Fucking dumb. Just, where are you?
David.
There you go.
How you doing?
About as good as can be expected, but the news is not good.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, me neither.
I know you did that fucking jewelry job.
I didn't do that.
Seriously, you're imagining things.
Fuck you.
Oh, such a great liar.
I did it. Arrest me. You know what? You'll be saving my life. Because you called it, motherfucker.
What?
You called it.
Trevor.
a couple days ago. But we haven't really talked about anything either.
But if no, when
was it a couple days ago? I think it was just like an hour ago.
South of the Canadian border. Passage of time's a little weird this game.
Oh, we got problems. Yeah, no shit.
I think they just always assume times passed between missions because you could be doing other shit.
So,
okay.
If your problems are my problems, then I guess that means that my problems are sort of.
No, it doesn't work that way. It is not a two-way street, sir. It is a one-way street. And the one-way.
What if I lose my job? Someone comes into my office, starts reading my files. They'll see the things I did. I know a lot of stuff. I can cop a plea, get 5 years, but you.
Welcome to the rest of GTA 5's story. Prick.
What?
It's just people doing this to you.
No. You know, like, okay.
Well, I got this reason why you gotta help me, whether you like it or not. Is the rest of the story of the game,
okay,
basically.
So here's the thing.
With occasional bank heists.
GTA 3 didn't do that.
What do you need?
Like, GTA 3 did not do that, rely on that at all. It was just like...
Well, that was a game where you're openly trying to
you were trying to become something...
Yeah, you're trying to become the head, like, a big mafia
guy. GTA 4 relied on that a lot. GTA 4 was a lot of fucking, like, well, this is what you have to do if you want... You know, it's like, you just have to take my shit because you can't do anything about it. Or you're in a bad...
GTA 4 was, he was actively trying to find work, too.
Yeah, but I'm saying... But it was also the thing, like, oh, your brother's a fucking prick, so you have to do this for me because your brother's an asshole. And it's like...
Oh!
Oh, okay. And it's like same with this
he
game.
He knocked
it's
you
like,
out because you need to sneak in. You need to sneak something out of the FBI building. FIB building? There we go.
The FIB building?
Yes.
I get it.
Yeah.
I get the joke.
It's so subtle. I don't know how you could possibly catch on. Welcome to the new, this is the best loading screen.
Take a peek. So they assume I'm dead?
The fat deposits on his hips and abdomen suggest a fondness for bleeder burgers.
What the hell was that?
More fat jokes for Michael. Oh, Jesus. I'm so sorry, Michael. This is a bad episode to be a black guy. First, the guy gets hit by the chair, and then I think you ran some over, too, and then you choke this guy out.
Come out!
Wait.
Hands in the air!
Welp.
Might be in the other room.
What?
Why would you say that out loud? Why are you narrating?
Out of there!
You wanna gonna get wrecked! Oh! I thought you were gonna choke him out.
No.
I didn't even know that was a move.
What, to punch him in the face?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's easy. You just press the fucking punch in the face button.
Did he pick up his gun?
No. I don't need to. I'm gonna punch people.
Oh. What's going on here?
You just don't have this happen?
Ferdinand Karamov.
No, I just forgot.
Some big black lady. Definitely not your guy.
Okay. The agency have the lower floors on lockdown to prevent a leak. I got a guy who can cut the power to give you some help. But you'll have to get upstairs if you're gonna get out.
Well, escapee time. Oh, here comes a bad guy. You should pull out a gun.
Stop.
You should pull out
Put
a gun.
Your hands on your head.
Or you could wreck him. You should have a gun by now. Holy fuck. How's he still alive?
He ain't.
That guy persisted for a while. You should check for your gun. This is going to be a problem if you don't use your gun. This is really going to be a problem. There's a lot of guys here. Do you just want to die? Like,
well, fuck, I couldn't change my gun. Damn it. I've landed on top of him.
I mean, I gave you ample warning.
I didn't realize there was going to be that many people. I thought it was just going to be like a stealth mission. Also, that guy did not show up on the radar, so that was helpful.
It's because they were spawning. Oh, now you just already have your gun held out. Like, here you go, jackass. Use the fucking gun. Whoa, what the fuck? Are the flat? What's up with the flashlight?
What the fuck?
Careful. Oh.
What the fuck?
It'd be a little more subtle if you didn't have your fucking flashlight on. Jesus. You're dead. Why is Michael turning on a flashlight every time he shoots at somebody? It's not exactly necessary. You're about to die.
I realize this. Thank you. The problem being that I don't really have an option.
You can hide behind a wall.
Yeah, but I mean, I don't. These guys just fucking show up out of nowhere, and they shoot me through windows.
Which is why you hide. And when you take cover, you can heal without getting shot.
Can I reload? No, no, no. Okay.
How much ammo do you have?
59, 58.
Oh, holy fuck!
What the fuck just happened?
You jumped and then you hit the dive button.
Dive, Akiku.
You did the trick I taught you how to do before, but then you forgot that it was a trick.
I have three.
What are you pressing to reload?
Swear. Circle.
Try circle. There you go.
There you go.
Just gotta remember how to play this game. It's been a while.
Whatever. Fucking. It's been a while since. Oh my god. I didn't realize.
I actually prioritized this for our recording session because we had people like, where's the fucking new episodes? I'm sad. I'm like, oh. I'm
well,
sorry.
Good. You get the name of our channel.
I'm so sorry.
Sad games. You're the sad ones.
It was a trick. This is performance art.
Oh my god. Get the fuck out of here.
Oh, Jesus. You should take cover.
Seriously, just let me go. Just let me stop doing a
so
shitty mission.
Was that a health item?
You're a threat to national security.
Where was the health item?
Table? No, it's a green box. Damn it. I'm trying to help you out here.
Oh, Jesus, fuck!
That guy was on the map for a while.
Yeah, but I didn't realize he could just fucking go through the door. I thought he was, like, stuck. I thought it was, like, an invisible wall for him. I'm a fucking... No, I gotta heal.
Fucking, this door with no lock on, it's closed, I'm doomed.
Well, I thought it was one of those things where the AI can't progress through the door. I don't know why. I just fucking thought so.
I mean, health item! Yes! Now all you need is a checkpoint.
What?
Go on the stairs. Stairs. There you go. Congratulations.
Michael, your weapons will be in the black trash bag. The evidence will
deck him! You have bad. Is that you have issues with peripheral vision, don't you?
What?
You have issues with peripheral vision, don't you?
No, I just wasn't paying attention. I was trying to read that email.
That's exactly what that means.
Huh? No, I just wasn't. I like literally was not looking at anything else like I normally do. I have really good peripheral vision. I just was not paying attention.
I don't know. I'm seeing trends here.
Fuck you, dude. I'm tired. All right. I'm so fucking.
You don't see guys attacking you when you're reading text messages.
I'm so fucking tired. You don't even know. Look at this shit. Look how fucking boss nigga I am right now. Just walking up the stairs, shooting black people. That's the life. American dream. Right here, baby. I'm living it. Living it.
Years ago.
Who says it ever stopped? Just because Lincoln existed didn't mean slaves stopped existing.
New comment on Artemis, spaceship bridge simulator number one. This does look fun. What is this?
Let me just...
Do you want to read the name of the fucking video?
How did you even find this video?
That is concerning, right?
You just type in, like, space!
How do you randomly encounter an Artemis video and then wonder what it is?
Game with space in it!
I would assume that you found the video because you're looking it up, because you're not exactly one of our subscribers because the video was uploaded, like...
Oh.
6 months ago. It's not exactly like...
Is there any health items around?
Like, it's not exactly in your feed.
How do you know where a health item would be?
I don't know. It's just a green blinking square. It shows up sometimes. The patterns for where they show up is just weird sometimes. Like, in Franklin's... Oh, there's one.
Okay. Just as we were discussing.
Just on the floor in the pharmacy, I think? Like, in... Oh, that's not even... No, it's a storage facility. No. Oh, that is what you're doing. Okay. I thought you were about to commit suicide or something.
Ow.
Like, in Franklin's
hurt.
House, there's... Oh, so many holes in his arms.
Those are just bullet holes. It's okay.
I feel like they shouldn't acknowledge all of the places you've been shot during cutscenes.
Yeah, they definitely shouldn't.
The way they cover his bullet holes just looks really weird. And you always look like you're dying in every cutscene. Like, in Franklin's house, the fucking med kit is just on the kitchen sink. Next to the kitchen sink.
Oh my god.
Like, why?
How many fucking cops are on me? So I have 3 stars I need to lose?
Well, this was unusually good job at losing cops for you. I would just chill here for a little bit.
Go to this alley over here.
The other alley. Ooh, getting risky. Moving forward and shit.
Actually, I want to go into this alley because it has this...
So you hide behind this. Did you recognize this alley?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
What was that, Keith? I'm fucking terrible at playing video games and seeing shit? Fuck you!
No, I said you had bad peripheral vision.
Same difference.
This is memory. Those are two different things. Although you do have bad memory because you forgot how to drive and reload.
Whatever, I figured out where this was.
Here you go. Alright, oh, Colin Franklin. Forgot that character's finally showing up in this episode.
F. Hey, we need to talk. Quick, meet me at those oil derricks just outside town, El Burro Heights. And make sure you're not tailed.
Man, that don't sound too good, homie. Look, I'm on my way.
Just in case you were worried Franklin wasn't going to be in this episode.
I was pretty worried.
That oh-so-important character that you can play as.
Dave, the hell was that? You know how many spooks I just ran into?
I'm sorry. They're not nice people, if that's a consolation.
No!
Is this spooks a racial slur for black people?
Something in the shadows.
Is he aware of the jokes we're making?
Whoever finds maybe.
The are you, do you know how many spooks are just ran into? What?
No, I think spooks is what they call agents. That is a legitimate name. They call them spooks because like ghosts.
Oh, I'm pretty sure you're talking about. I'm pretty sure he's talking about cops.
No, he's talking. He's talking about like.
Oh, did you say agents?
Yeah.
Oh.
Are they agents? No.
Oh, I've never heard that slur before. I'm pretty sure it's not. I've heard it used for black people before.
I have not.
I have.
They call black people spooks?
I think I've heard that. I don't know.
Are you sure it wasn't spicks?
I'll have to reread the Huckleberry Finn.
I don't think they call them spooks. I think they call them spicks.
No, those are Spanish people. Oh. I mean Mexicans. Do you not know that?
Are you sure they didn't call them Negroes? I mean, Huckleberry Finn was pretty good about using the N-word all the fucking time.
Yeah, they were. Yes.
Like, they weren't really shy, but Tom Sawyer was not shy about using
it. I learned a lot of unfortunate racial slurs from Huckleberry Finn.
I learned a lot. I learned a lot of words that I.
I'm not a shitty person, but. I've become aware of some of them.
I became aware that I should have lived back in slave times.
Jesus. Holy fuck.
Because clearly I know a lot of things that I don't use very often, but they'd be fun to say without getting in trouble.
Jesus Christ.
Well, I'm not saying I'm racist. I'm just saying like
that's pretty. No, you're
no,
pretty,
I'm
pretty
saying
pretty
that
racist.
Some racial slurs just sound like fun words to say. Not to the people derogatorily, but just like they're just fun words. They're just funny words, I just think. I'm not saying, like, I don't care if I say it to a black person. I just
holy
care about
shit.
Saying, like, I just, like, I don't go around saying Negro.
It's gonna be hard to walk back from this one.
No, I don't go around saying, like, nigga to black people. I say it to whoever because it's a funny word. Like, it's a stupid word. Like, who puts two G's? Like, that's dumb. One score with you, I made more money than I ever did hustling. Ever did hustling. But, you know, it's the other shit that
I ain't got figured out. So what's the deal, man? What's the deal with the bureau, man? This clown. I mean, he's an okay guy. Fucking cocksucker. We did a deal a long time ago.
A little bit of contradiction there.
The way it was supposed to go. Wrong guy got killed.
What's the super low res everything on these characters' bodies right now?
Yeah. Action program.
He helped me. I didn't reveal secrets of his. And everything was cool. Problem started when recently I became unretired. I mean, he shows up, starts calling in favors, telling me to do shit. I mean, look, Franklin, I'm working for the fucking feds.
Oh, fuck, man.
Is this the first time
man,
he
yeah, and that ain't even the worst
showed up?
Part.
Yeah.
I ever tell you about Trevor?
Or it's the first time he told anybody.
I think so.
The FBI
shit,
guy showed up
when
you're doing the Facebook
honest.
Thing. He blew the guy's head up?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the last time I saw the FBI in the episode.
Well, let's bury this motherfucker. Oh, yeah.
Dude, no one knows about the FBI connection until now.
Oh.
Trevor thought that Michael was dead, and he hasn't told Franklin because he hasn't had a reason to.
I
because you generally don't
love
want,
how
you
Franklin,
generally don't want people to know about this
Franklin
shit.
Franklin and Trevor are wearing like the same sweatshirt.
Yeah, without even knowing it, because you're just dressing them up in the same uniform.
Oh, I'm gonna go get Michael the same uniform too.
Yeah, I'm surprised neither of them changed out of it yet.
Fuck. They better not fucking change out of it.
We've talked about this already.
It did happen, huh?
People just change clothes generally.
I forgot about that. Yeah, don't do that.
All right, man. Look, man. You help me. Way I see it, man. The least I can do is help you.
Now kiss.
Like next time we play, you could switch to Franklin.
Why did I show up to his play? Why did I show up to this meeting in my pajamas?
Those aren't pajamas.
Oh, it's like suit bottoms and a wife beater. Run me up a tree. Fuck that. What is that?
Because you were all dressed up until fucking.
Yeah, until I got knocked out and then pretended to be dead.
Autopsy time started.
What if I didn't wake up at that time?
I'll find something for you.
Ben, you know.
How did that guy know I was gonna wake up before I got cut?
Well, if he died, then...
All right, man.
He'd still be not having
I'm
to deal with your problems anymore.
Then Trevor would come after him.
Would he?
Yes.
Trevor doesn't even know about that guy.
Trevor shouldn't fucking know anything, but he does.
Trevor's magical Jesus, man. No, he hasn't known anything magically or anything. He knows about Michael because Michael fucking got quoted on TV. And that gave away the fact that he was still alive.
Not necessarily. Out of just one quote, and he's like, that has to be Michael.
Yeah.
Okay. I guess.
It's a very, well, not just a random quote of anyone doing something ever, but a specific quote that Michael did during robberies was quoted at a robbery. That kind of narrows
hey,
down.
What, Tracy?
What's up? Are you joking? You ruined my life.
I don't give a fuck.
I thought I'd already ruined your life. Remember after that boat thing?
Take
yep.
this seriously. Do you
no.
know how bad I wanted
You don't
that?
Deserve it. Well, yeah, that's how I made
you'll
you.
You'll get over it. You'll see. I did you a favor.
Never! I hate you!
I'll drown you.
Why did you call
I'll
me?
I'll drown you in the bay. How does it make you
why
feel?
Why the fuck did you even call me? Did you just want to, like, yell at me?
Yeah, that's what she
because
does.
Guess what? You live in my house. I'm going to go home and fucking murder you.
Yep.
Like.
Mission accomplished. Zach, go punch a woman so we get on the episode.
That's what I'm looking for right now. I'm cruising. I'm patrolling the streets looking for women.
Jesus Christ. It's strangely hard to find.
They are. Why are women so fucking...
They're supposed to be half the people, right?
Yeah.
Guy. It's like the moment we're ending an episode, suddenly only men are in the streets.
Yeah,
it's got a weird, derpy-ass backpack.
It's getting kind of irritating that I chose women to be a thing that I punch before it's over.
Yeah.
Because they seem to be
Have you done it every single episode?
Yes,
you know?
Except for the... Yes, I did. I have done it in every single episode. And you know what? If that's
trend.
A problem with anybody, why don't you go punch a woman and see how fun it feels?
It's amusing to me primarily just because when you just deck someone, the way they ragdoll is so perfect.
Skirt.
There's a sort of hesitation to before they fall over.
Next time on Side Games!
Oh!